the knapsack, the hat, and the horn. There were once three brothers who had fallen deeper and deeper into poverty, and at last their need was so great that they had to endure hunger and had nothing to eat or drink. Then said they, "We cannot go on thus. We had better go into the world and seek our fortune." They therefore set out, and had already walked over many a long road and many a blade of grass, but had not yet met with good luck. One day they arrived in a great forest, and in the midst of it was a hill, and when they came nearer, they saw that the hill was all silver. Then spoke the eldest, "Now I have found the good luck I wished for, and I desire nothing more." He took as much of the silver as he could possibly carry, and then turned back and went home again. But the two others said, "We want something more from good luck than mere silver," and did not touch it, but went onwards. After they had walked for 2 days longer without stopping, they came to a hill which was all gold. The second brother stopped, took thought with himself, and was undecided. "What shall I do?" said he. "Shall I take for myself so much of this gold that I have sufficient for all the rest of my life, or shall I go farther?" At length he made a decision, putting as much into his pockets as would go in, said farewell to his brother, and went home. But the third said, "Silver and gold do not move me. I will not renounce my chance of fortune. Perhaps something better still will be given me." He journeyed onwards, and when he had walked for 3 days, he got into a forest which was still larger than the one before, and never would come to an end. And as he found nothing to eat or drink, he was all but exhausted. Then he climbed up a high tree to find out if up there he could see the end of the forest, but so far as his eye could pierce, he saw nothing but the tops of trees. Then he began to descend the tree again, but hunger tormented him, and he thought to himself, "If I could but eat my fill once more." When he got down, he saw with astonishment a table beneath the tree, richly spread with food, the steam of which rose up to meet him. "This time," said he, "my wish has been fulfilled at the right moment." And without inquiring who had brought the food or who had cooked it, he approached the table and ate with enjoyment until he had appeased his hunger.